In this problem, we're given a quadratic function in general form. We want to find f of 3, the equation of the axis of symmetry, the vertex, the x-intercepts, the y-intercept, and then finally graph the function. So let's start with a quick review. The graph of a quadratic function. The graph of a quadratic function will form a parabola, as we see here in blue. Notice this parabola opens up, which means a would be positive. If a was negative, the parabola would open down. Every parabola has an axis of symmetry, which is pictured here in green. It's a vertical line that cuts the parabola in half, or we say the parabola is symmetrical across this line, which means if we folded this parabola across this line, it would match up perfectly with the other half. And if the quadratic function is in general form, as it is here, the equation of this vertical line is x equals negative b divided by 2a. Next, if the parabola opens up like this, the vertex is the lowest point on the parabola, which should be this point here. And since the axis of symmetry passes through the vertex, this equation also tells us the x-coordinate of the vertex. And then since this point is on the parabola, we can substitute this x value into the function to determine the y-coordinate. Now if the parabola opened down, the vertex would be the highest point on the parabola. And then the points where the parabola intersects the x-axis are the x-intercepts. This parabola has two x-intercepts, one here and one here. To find these points, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x, because every point on the x-axis has a y-coordinate equal to 0. And then the point where the parabola intersects the y-axis is called the y-intercept, this point here. To find the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y, since every point on the y-axis has an x-coordinate equal to 0. Now let's go back to our problem. We first want to determine f of 3, which means we'll substitute 3 for x and then evaluate the function. We need to be careful with this first term. It's going to be negative and then positive 3 squared plus 4 times 3 plus 2. So here we'll have negative 9 plus 12 plus 2, which would be equal to positive 5. Since f of 3 is equal to positive 5, this also tells us that the point with coordinates 3, 5 would be on our graph. Next, we'll determine the equation of the axis using this formula here. We need to recognize that a is equal to negative 1 and b is equal to positive 4. So we'd have x equals negative 4 divided by 2 times negative 1. This simplifies to positive 2. So the equation of the axis is x equals 2. Next, to determine the coordinates of the vertex, we already know the x-coordinate would also be positive 2. And then to determine the y-coordinate, we'll substitute 2 into the function for x. So f of 2 is going to be equal to negative 2 squared plus 4 times 2 plus 2. Again, be careful, we're squaring positive 2, not negative 2 here. So we have negative 4 plus 8 plus 2, which is equal to 6. So our y-coordinate is 6. Next, we want to determine the x-intercepts, so we'll set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Remember, y is equal to f of x, so this would give us the equation 0 equals negative x squared plus 4x plus 2. Unlike our last example, this is not factorable, so we'll have to use the quadratic formula to solve this equation, where a is equal to negative 1, b is 4, and c is 2. So we'd have x equals negative b, or negative 4, plus or minus the square root of b squared, or 4 squared, that would be 16, minus 4 times a times c, or 4 times negative 1 times 2, that's negative 8, all over 2 times a, or 2 times negative 1, which is negative 2. Let's look at this square root for a moment. 16 minus negative 8 would become 16 plus 8, or 24, and the square root of 24 is equal to the square root of 4 times 6. 4 is a perfect square, so this would simplify it to 2 square root 6. So we'd have x equals negative 4 plus or minus 2 square root 6 divided by negative 2. This still simplifies though. Let's break this up into two fractions. We'd have negative 4 divided by negative 2 plus or minus 2 square root 6 divided by negative 2. Well, negative 4 divided by negative 2 simplifies to 2. And then here, this would simplify to negative 1, but we do have a plus or minus, so the sign really doesn't matter. This would just be plus or minus square root 6. So we'll list the x-intercepts two ways. We'll first list the exact coordinates, and then we'll get decimal approximations so we can plot them on the coordinate plane. So we could list the x-intercepts as 2 plus square root 6 comma 0 and 2 minus square root 6 comma 0. These would be the exact x-intercepts, but we wouldn't be able to plot them in this form. For decimal approximations, 2 plus square root 6 is approximately 4.45, so we'll have 4.45 comma 0, and then 2 minus square root 6 is approximately negative 0.45. So that was quite a bit of work. Luckily, to determine the y-intercept will be a lot easier. We'll set x equal to 0 and solve for y. Looking at our function again, if x is 0, notice that we'll have 0 plus 0 plus 2, y would be equal to 2, which means our y-intercept would be the point 0, 2. So now let's take all this information and make a nice graph of our parabola. I always like to start by sketching the axis of symmetry, so let's sketch the line x equals 2. That would be this vertical line here. Next, the vertex has coordinates 2, 6, which would be this point here. Remember, since a is negative 1, this parabola opens down. We determined f of 3 equals 5, which means the point 3 comma 5 would be on the graph, this point here. And because of the symmetry across the axis here, we know there must be another point on the parabola 1 unit to the left of the axis, which would be this point here. Next, we'll sketch the y-intercept, which is the point 0, 2, or this point here. And notice that this point is 2 units to the left of the axis, which means there must be another point 2 units to the right of the axis here. And then we'll go ahead and sketch the approximate x-intercepts. We have negative 0.45 comma 0, it's approximately here, and 4.45 comma 0 would be somewhere in here. So our graph would look something like this. I hope you found this helpful.